What's up, I'm Brian here doing another video for you guys, and this time ahead of the Fan First Tuesday, which HasbroPULSE is planning, they decided to reveal a couple of Transformers toys, and these are official reveals this time, I want to make that clear. But yeah, usually these are just to hype us up, so we're going to take a look at these figures, starting off with the Blitzwing. Now, we already know about the Blitzwing, so I'm going to make it quick. And the tank mode does look pretty decent in these images. I'm liking it a little bit more, although I'm really noticing the cockpit sticking out of the front. However, what I will say is apparently that it is accurate to the cartoon, so take it or leave it at this point. But we also have the jet mode, and I'm still not a huge fan of the jet mode, which is kind of funny that the cockpit looks like it sticks out less than the tank mode, so that's kind of weird. But yeah, it's got way too much kibble going on at the bottom. I know that this figure has to fit in three different modes, but that is way too much going on. It is not pleasant. But the top of the jet, for the most part, does look pretty clean and does look pretty good. And then we take a look at the robot mode, and this is where everything comes together. He also does have two red fists, which I don't think is going to be part of the Menasaur, because if it was, then he would have a 1 out of 6 or whatever, because if you notice, all the other Stunticons have a 1 out of 5, 2 out of 5 type thing on the packaging. He does not, so I don't think that's going to be the case. And if it is the same hands, I feel like Motor Master is going to come with those hands as well. But anyways, focusing on Blitzwing, he does come with the two guns, so that's awesome. And yeah, I think the proportions does look pretty good. The yellow head does look awesome, and yeah, I'm liking it. Some people are upset that it doesn't come with the triple face, and to that I say, that was more something that was significant to the animated form. This is going for the G1, so it doesn't need that. But let's take a look at the packaging before the actual big reveal, the latest reveal. The package does look pretty good. I thought we were going into Wildrider, but then I screwed up. But anyways, now we're going into Wildrider, and the car mode. Let's just let this sink in, because the car mode does look really good. I am so satisfied. It looks like a retro car, and you do get a pair of guns, much like the drag strip, and a cannon attached to the top, which is fine. Although you do have the portholes on the top, so that's going to look kind of weird. But the colors does look good. And there are also two good things about this. One, it's not that off-road whatever character from Combiner Wars. And two, they didn't rename it Breakneck. This is officially Wildrider. I love the red stripe, the gray color. It's kind of like a bluish, almost like a steel tint to it. And then the red windows. Oh, it's just gorgeous. And then we take a look at the robot mode, and it kind of ruins it. Now, for the most part, when you take a look at the actual robot itself, that looks really good to me. I like the boxy aesthetic of the arms. They look a little thin, but I'm fine with it. I actually like the shape of the legs. It kind of reminds me of some of the third-party figures for some reason. But then you take a look at the torso. The front of the torso looks fine. Again, very thin, but I'm okay with it. The backpack is the problem. So you got the hood that kind of flips up and doesn't feel like it flips down all the way, so it looks weird. And then you've got the two sides of, I believe that's the front of the car, that just kind of fold up to the back. And I'm not into that. That kind of kills the mood. I don't even mind the hood or bumper section on the back there. It's the wheels on the side, because they just stick out way too far. It is so obnoxious, so terrible. I can already hear Perspective End complaining about it. It's just, that does not look good at all. I'm sorry, they needed to do something better than that. I get that maybe this figure will be able to disconnect, because I did guess that drag strip might be able to connect as part of the leg instead of just part of the arm, so maybe there's a gimmick there. He does have the same portholes or similar portholes, so I imagine that continuing on, yes, that's going to be the way to connect these guys onto Motor Master to make the Menasaur. I do like the coloring. I think the head does look pretty good for the most part. It's just that kibble on the side there. That's the only thing that really kills it for me. Everything else I'm totally fine with, or I'm just okay with. It's that kibble. I'm not into it. But the package does look pretty good, because it's got that purple color scheme, and I do like the car with the guns on top. They actually put the kibble on top, and they actually made it look kind of exciting, but man, does that thing kind of ruin it. The one thing, you know. Anyways, what do you guys think? Please comment below. Let me know. Please like, comment, share, subscribe, and all those fun doodads. And I will see you guys next time.
All Spark TV. Now that's just prime.